Good day. Today I'm going to do a controlled pour with many different techniques. I have an idea in my head that I'm working towards. I'm going to embellish this pour. After it's done, I have a series I want to do, so I'm going to see how the first one comes out. So, I'm going to start. This part is going to be sky. Excuse my throat. So I'm going to put blue up here. I've mixed blue, turquoise blue, with some white. And I'm going to kind of spread it around because that's going to be kind of my sky area. I didn't mix this paint really well. I'm going to try to save a little bit just in case I need it to touch up. I'm just going to spread it with a spatula or a palette knife, a flat one. I just started thinking about this painting on one of my painting groups. Somebody did a painting like this, but a painting. I think it was Paul Martin, and he got the idea off the internet, and now I can't remember that guy's name, but if I can find it, I will put it in the description. Because, I mean, we all get ideas from different people. We have to, because, I mean, they're out there. Doesn't mean we copy them exactly, but I'm making this my own version. Make sure I get paint all down the sides, because I like to think that anybody could hang this anyway, you know, without a frame. I've got to get some blue up top because it's hard to see if it's flowing over there. Kind of started to, but I could pour a little bit up there and get it spread over that part. I might leave it sideways too. I want to try blowing some clouds in with the straw. See how that works. Why shouldn't it work? It should look fluffy and... I just about spilt my green. So as I said, I never mixed this paint really, really well. It's just kind of... So there will be different tones all through it. I'm going to put some down here too, because it's going to be green, but I think it could use some blue in it. So I'm trying to leave about the same amount of paint on everywhere. But if it has a little texture, it has a little texture. What's right or wrong? Oh, I got my towel in my lap. I'll wipe off my palette knife. I guess I should have brought a container of water, but wiping will do. Now I'm going to drip a little bit of white in and blow it around for a few clouds. Why won't it work? Few different sizes, shapes, nothing else, I'll mix them in. I don't like the way it looks. It'll just make lighter areas in the clouds, but I want to experiment and try it. Now, none of these paints have silicone in them. There might be a little bit in the brown, only because the brown is made by what I scraped off of a canvas. If I really don't like one, and occasionally you get one that is like, oh, nope. And then I scrape it off and put it into a bucket, and then, well, it's always brown. So it could have some silicone in it. So first, I'm going to blow these clouds around. More and on to the next one. Most of my paints I let set overnight. So they have time to the bubbles kind of pop. Any that don't, I do that, bang them, and they're gone. So I don't use a torch. Now for the next color, it's going to kind of be treesy. So I'm going to put some green in there. Because it's just going to kind of be background in there. A few faint trees in there. I'm going to kind of blend those two together so they're kind of sky and trees. So there's no definite. Pounce a little bit extra in there, but I kind of want it like it's sky kind of peeking through, a little bit of blues, a little bit of greens. It's just forest or whatever back there. I'm thinking this kind of has to be a little bit jumbled and mumbled and not too thick, because I want to scrape I guess I should pull any down here, because I'm going to put some darker greens in here, and I can have some highlights scraped in there from underneath. So probably should do the brown next, because it's got to be behind her. In the background. So I got this bit of brown that I had, like I said, scraped off. Just gonna take and coat my popsicle stick and put some trees. Background. Maybe little trees. Like I said, I'm just kind of making them look like branches coming through. Scraping them in and around. And like I said, it's an abstract, so nothing's perfect. Scrape some little ones for background, so I have some smaller ones in there, not all big ones. Oop. Wow. Don't like that. Don't like something, you just go in. said, it's an abstract, so it's not perfect. And this is a springtime one. It's supposed to feel like renewal. Like spring does. So I'm using the bright. Summers, they get darker. I might put some little drops of this darker green in here and kind of spread it around. Just add a little bit of different colors. I'm boring. Nothing's worse than a boring bore. We all know that. Now if I had put silicone, I would have got little bits of cells in here, but I really didn't want it in here. If some of you do one, you try it in there, see, you'll get a different complete effect than I got. Of course, because it'll make cells. I'm not making cells at all. It's kind of getting a feeling of a foresty kind of feeling. Get a little bit of browns in there mixed in, so kind of looks like little bits of shadows. Or it's playing with paint. Play. That's the fun part of it. I was also thinking that I could kind of use some of the pure color and maybe just try the tines of a fork. Just scrape some grass in. Hard to not get too much paint though. And bubbles as I'm doing it, so it's not a bad thing. I wonder if I shouldn't put like that. Scrape a few longer ones up. Let them be what they are. So the forest kind of melds in with the trees a little. So I'm going to put the trees down a little soon, but I wanted to get them kind of in there. Oh my gosh. I don't know if you guys know how mesmerizing it can be when you're working on these paintings. You just kind of lose yourself in the flow of what's happening. Now, I might put little bits of the dark brown in just to I don't think it's grass though. shadowy areas. Kind of break up the regularity of what I... did with the grass, so it just doesn't look... the place has its little darker areas and its little... grass portions, dirt. Maybe there's some dirt in here. A little. There's a place maybe, help life would look a little better just to get some different tones. Kind of a lay of the land. Not really, wasn't paying attention. Come on, let's keep going. I do need to kind of settle the trees down. Might look like they're kind of planted. The ones that are closer anyway. Plant down so they look like they might be in the ground. The back one, well, I'm going to put a little bit of got a few too many, but that's alright. I'll kind of meld that one in behind this one. I don't see it. And this one I gotta build because you can't have something standing up in the air. It's not really air, but it's like trees. Now I should be using my little stick to make the squiggles because that would work better. Thing. So I might have to use a brown because there's got a color obviously. Pick and chooses, get them thicker. Background one of the seven little ones. They're not going to be the focal ones anyway. They're just going to be the ones for when I push it into the paint. I'm just kind of trying to plant a few so they look like they hit the ground or go into the ground or just so they don't look like they stand out too much. It's funny how that just just that little bit of color. Brings it down and kind of settles it, makes it look like it could grow in there instead of just being there. Okay. Now, I'm not sure exactly how I'm going to, well, that's quite a bit lighter. Don't like that. It's too light. Trying to think of my characters too that I'm putting on here. One's gonna be there. And one more back in here. So I need something that I'm just gonna use dark green I should use a lighter. As I said, it's more of a summer, spring. So the leaves, I'm just going to kind of pounce a little bit of color and see how that works. Just wadded up a piece of paper towel. Put this in my hand, a light green. See if it'll work for... making it look like there's some leaves in there. T seems to be pulling up instead of adding two. So I will wet a brush. Just a brush that I should stick a brush here just in case I decide I want to use a brush to. That's not working either. Interesting. See, it's a whole lot different than painting. I think I need it in a bottle. So, I'm going to put some of the green in a bottle and drop it around. Maybe I'll put a few colors because there's some room in there. Bit of the darker blue or green, sorry. And the rest of this color. And drop it around and see if I can get the effect that way. If I can, perfect. That didn't work. I like to do that. once I get this kind of pulled out, this will be all. I'll be doing today. Anyway, I'm just going to give you ideas of different ways to control your pouring. Doesn't always have to be done the same way. Wipe it on, we can pour it on. Anyway, thanks for watching, and hope you like, share, and subscribe.